get started. We're going to be installing a PVC grounded dust collection system here in the Geek Pub shop. And originally I was going to use these aluminum blast gates, and I was going to use an Arduino and some servo motors and automate them, similar to what Bob Claggett did over at I Like to Make Stuff. And that's when Rockler called me and said, hey, we already sell a complete automated dust collection system that includes blast gates, it has switches, they offer remote controls, and all kinds of little individual components that you can get for it. And so that's what we're going to be installing today in the Geek Pub. And we'll go through all of the individual pieces as we go through it, but the first thing we're going to do is install the switch on the dust collector. So let's get started. So all you have to do to install it is simply plug it into the outlet and then plug the dust collector into the iSwitch. And then you can test it by flipping the switch. So you could stop here and you would have already made a massive upgrade to your shop. Just being able to carry around this remote control anywhere in the shop and turn the dust collector on and off remotely is a massive upgrade for most people. But we're not going to stop here. So let's keep going. In order to hang the PVC pipe on the wall, I'm going to use these hose clamps, and I've drilled a small hole in the back of the clamp that will accept this screw. And behind the clamp, I'm going to use these washers. And that is because the PVC fittings have an overlap, and I need to compensate for that on the pipe. And then I'll just screw this to the wall. I'm using silicone caulk to put these together rather than PVC cement, and the reason why is that gives me the ability in the future to take it apart. You just have to use a little bit of heat from a heat gun and you can knock it back apart with a 2x4. These adapters from Rockler allow you to adapt the PVC pipe over to standard dust collection fittings. To install the blast gates, I'm going to use both adhesive and I'm going to put a screw in from the side because I'm not going to use pipe clamps. So it's very important that you ground PVC dust collection, and that is because it's very prone to building up static electricity, and that could result in a dust fire. And because of that, Rockler makes this really cool grounding kit, and it's basically a braided wire that you wrap around the outside of the PVC. And I'm going to drill holes every few feet and insert these screws, and that way I will make contact with both the air on the inside and on the outside. So one of the things that I wanted in the shop was a floor sweep, and this just allows you to sweep the floor directly into the dust collector rather than having to get out a broom and a dustpan and do it the old-fashioned way. And this isn't something that will get used constantly, so I'm just going to connect it with a manual blast gate so that I can open it and close it as needed. And then from there, I'll just use a piece of flexible hose to connect the floor sweep. I'm going to use a hose clamp to connect this because after I use it a few times, I may change my mind on how I want it laid out. So the last thing we want to do is ground the blast gate to the grounding system, and we'll just do that by removing a screw and then putting it back in with the ground wire in place. Okay, so before we move on, I wanted to take just a minute to talk about this system and how it works. And the system is wireless and it is programmable. There's little dip switches on each component. And that allows you to program them and lets you set the tool number, the frequency, in case you wanted to have, you know, two shops next door to each other or something like that, or you had multiple dust collectors. You could set different blast gates and different tools to operate on different dust collectors, as well as you can set different tools to open different blast gates, and that's all programmable through these little dip switches. The system itself is wireless, so you don't have to run any wires for it other than you do have to plug it into power. To operate the gate itself, which can be controlled manually from a little switch here. So every tool needs to have one of these little iVac tool modules installed. And these basically just connect over the outside of the power cord and they sense the magnetic induction in the wire, which operates the tool. Now again, these have dip switches so that you can program them to a specific tool. This one would be connected, so for example, to the table saw, and then that would operate the table saw's blast gate along with turning on the vacuum. Now, you can also at any time operate the vacuum with a remote control, and you can have multiple of these if you would like, and they can be programmed also to operate a blast gate or just turn the dust collector on and off. So let's go ahead and finish up. Okay, so to program the remote for the table saw, I simply need to change it to on, and that will set it to my system address, and then for the tool address, it is on, and off. And that's it, it's programmed for this tool. And then installing the tool is as simple as clamping the remote around the tool that you want to control the dust collector. So Rockler also sent me this really cool quick disconnect system for tools that you might move around the shop. I love this thing. Okay, so now when I turn on the tool, it opens the blast gate and then turns on the dust collector. And I have the system programmed so that when I turn the tool off, it immediately closes the blast gate, but it runs the dust collector for another 5 seconds. And I have to tell you, having an automated dust collection system in the shop is a dream. I can't tell you how many times I would go over to a tool and make a couple of cuts and never turn the dust collection system on because it was too much of a pain to go over and drag the hose across the room, connect it to that tool, and then go back and turn the dust collector on, and then turn the tool on, and then go back to the tool I was using previously. I had to repeat all of that again. So the greatest thing about having an automated dust collection system, I'm actually going to use it all the time. Well, hey guys, I hope you enjoyed seeing how a system like this works in my shop and maybe it will work in your shop. And I'd like to send out a special shout out to Rockler for sending me the components for this video. Thanks guys. Well, you can help me out if you'll hit that like button and then subscribe to my channel on YouTube. Well, hey, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.